Nagorny will be up first in this floor final, all-around bronze medalist. Anyway, they'll all be introduced to us, and then we'll be into it. Short, sweet and powerful, these apparatus finals. A change to the look of it was accommodating some television requirements, I suppose. We can talk about that a little bit later, but Nagorny up first from Spain's Ray Zapata, Muldaur of the United States, Artem Dolgopyat, top qualifier, Kim Hansul and Ryo Shung-hyun of Korea, XIAO Ruoteng of China, and Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan. They are your eight. Plenty of interest around whether Israel can do something special today.
Yes, well, they haven't won a medal before at Olympic Games. In fact, they've only been in a couple of finals, so this will be interesting. Dolgopyat is the top qualifier, but we have really good equations here. Some people are coming up with more difficulty, other people their execution is strong. We see a couple of gymnasts today who are going to add some difficulty in.
Well, if we get here early enough, we can get a sneak preview of what they seem to have in mind, and a little move from Nagorny to keep an eye out for.
Yes, I think he's going to show us his triple pike, which is the only man in the world to do it. He debuted it earlier this year in around April at the European Championships. He hasn't competed it here yet. I think he was going for stable routine, but we saw him warming it up and it looked fantastic. So let's hope that he competes it well. He's up first, so he's got to put it all out there.
A limit of two per country, seven nations represented, two in from Korea. Representing ROC, 24-year-old from Moscow, Nikita Nagorny. Born in the Dominican Republic, representing Spain, Rayderley Zapata. Muldaur, born in South Korea, representing the United States. Dolgopyat, top qualifier, as mentioned, with a 15-2. 25 from Seoul, fifth qualifier. The youngest by some margin in this final, just 18 years of age, Ryu Sung-hyun. XIAO Ruoteng, 25 years of age from Beijing, already with two medals. And Milad Karimi, 22-year-old student from Almaty. They are our finalists for the floor.
The order is interesting because if you're a top qualifier and you're up first, it is a random draw, it's not seeded, so you've got to work out whether you want to put in your full difficulty or not, and those who are going earlier probably don't have a great choice. Those who are going later can have a look to see what actually happened, and they may be able to make some adjustments.
Well, nerves and in some cases fatigue will play a part here. Those with a busy program like XIAO Ruoteng and Nagorny doesn't do them any favours, but obviously they're very strong, but the muscles get tired after qualifying and team and all around.
Well, that's Rayderley Zapata there, and he's only done floor, that's it.
Yeah.
And he's, he had just one early round, and that's all he did. But we're going to start with Nagorny. He's showing the triple pike. This is the first time it's been done at a world or Olympic level. It's been done at European Championships. It will lift his difficulty score by 0.4 to 6.6, which will put him well in line being a gold medal contender, a true gold medal contender. He's a strong worker, he's very clean and generally stable.
He's awaiting the green light from the judges to commence our competition for apparatus finals in this first session.
Triple pike is rated as an I skill. A is the easiest at 0.1, and I is right up at 0.9. The most difficult skill in men's gymnastics.
Let's see if he can master it. We begin the men's floor. Nikita Nagorny.
It's stressful about this first landing. Has to have just the right amount of adrenaline. No, stumbles backwards for a big deduction, but he had to try. Double pike half out. Probably a bit unsettled from that first line. The third line done beautifully. He just looks off at the moment. His rhythm's not quite there. Wondering for a minute whether his feet were sore, but I think it's just general rhythm. Long pause before the last line. Finishing with a double-double and it's short. Disappointing for Nagorny.
Well, that is a rough start to the competition, and Nagorny, he knows it won't be good enough. But as you say, he had to go for broke, as we call it, because he knows the quality that's coming after him. Zapata, Dolgopyat.
He did a perfect one in warm-up, but warm-up and competition are two different things. It's just an incredible skill. He's short on it. Just didn't have quite enough height. Second line, double pike, half out. He's been opening with that line, and once again, he's short. You know, he's done 18 routines competition, and the legs events, floor and vault, really take a lot out of you.
And we have to bear in mind how much warm-up is done. It's, they're in that hall for hours.
Yeah, well, they do just enough, I think. The men tend to do less than the women. This was his big chance at gold, I would say. Of all the apparatus, it's his best shot, but not to be for him, I would say. Mind you, there's seven more men to go, and we don't know what they're going to do yet. And Triple Tuck was debuted in 1987, so almost 25 years ago. Or was that 35 years ago? I can't do my maths.
He's already a team gold medalist, so... and a bronze in the all-around. There's actually five gymnasts who already have two medals, and four of them are in tonight's competition. Nagorny, one of them. But after some stumbles, he's unlikely to add to his tally. We'll see. As you say, anything can happen. The next seven competitors also have to find form.
Oh, he's still got a... I think a reasonably big score coming up.
I think his ankles are sore. He's got an ouch. Yeah.
No, 13.066.
Yeah.
That's right. Difficulty 6.4.
Now, Rayderley Zapata, or Ray, as he likes to be known, the 28-year-old originally from the Dominican Republic, moved to Spain when he was 9. Nearly gave it away at 17, and here he is 11 years later. And he can put some big moves out there as well, Liz.
He can. He's got an open with a skill named after himself, the Zapata. Saw him warm it up. He's a very good front tumbler. Front layout. 1.5 makes it look easy, but he's the only man in the world doing that skill. Combination front line again with a step backwards. Double pike half out. He really does favour the front tumbling. He's well suited to it. And yet another one. Just amazing. combination line, getting cheers from sidelines from all his supporters. Finishing with a strong double layout.
He's happy. He kept it in the area. That first row seemed to have so much forward momentum. I wondered how he was possibly going to stop it, but his landing was perfect. You know, he's been at the top for a while. He was third on floor at the World Championships in Glasgow 2015. He's had three top tens on floor at European Championships.
So here he goes, the double front, 1.5 out, just from a handspring. Combination line into a double pike. That's a big combination line too. On handspring, double pike, half out. His landings were very stable.
He's a powerful worker. And a pretty passionate man by the look of him after completing the routine. And of course, this will surely take him to the top after just two routines. The problems experienced by Nagorny, we all saw. Olympia. That is the name of his daughter, Olympia.
That's very cute.
Yeah. And a 14.933, the score to beat. I'm sure the family's seen it. Yul Muldaur now of the United States.
A top score in any round of floor here at this Tokyo 2020 competition has been a 15.2. That was in the first day of competition in the qualification round. So above a 15 will be necessary. From a run, 3.5 twist. Half in, half out. He's a very quick worker.
Quite a different build to Zapata.
Yes, different very
style.
Different.
Yeah.
Falters on that skill. Might be missing the value of it, depending if you complete it enough. That would be slightly unsettling. Gives an air of confidence about him.
Hmm.
Finishing with the triple twist.
2019, he was recognised as the top NCAA gymnast in the United States. He was studying University of Oklahoma. It's quite an honour in US gymnastics to reach that level, be accorded that honour.
There's the half in, half out, or it's Arabian double front, half out. Now, let's have a look here at what happens with his flares. Drags the foot, doesn't complete the skill, so he's been getting around, or he has been getting a 5-8 difficulty score, and I have to think that that's going to be affected, and also, of course, the brush of the foot on the floor.
So we await the score for Yul Muldaur. He's got a good shock of hair now, but when he was a baby, he didn't have hair for a long time, and his parents nicknamed him Yul after Yul Brynner. And it's stuck with him. I think he's proud of it. Fourth on floor at the 2018 World Championships. Third in 2017. It's a pet event of his, and he needs 14.933 or more. The top qualifier is next.
keep an eye out for the difficulty score as it comes up.
Hard to read his mood. 13.533. Oh, he's well short of Zapata. Almost 1.5 points. Goodness. Anyway, on we go. And this is one to watch. Artem Dolgopyat. Can he make history for Israel?
You'd have to say it's his for the taking. He has a 6.6 difficulty. His execution has been even, so hasn't gone for too much of one at the expense of the other. He has an amazingly difficult first line.
Two-time world silver medalist on floor.
Well, that's double front half out. I apologise, I thought he was going for his other line. Front four, front 2.5 combination. Maybe it's he's going to do it in this line. Oh, double-double. I'm wondering if he's just changed his first line for safety, for security.
These boys have options.
He's outside of the floor and he's actually quite off the centre of the diagonal. A lot of nerves here, I'd say. Russian Wender swings, his option for his non-acrobatic elements.
Well, that's a good finish from Dolgopyat, a second inside the time allowed, but he wasn't quite there, was he?
Well, he's normally doing a triple twisting double tuck, and I saw him warm it up and it looked really good. But the first line that he chose, I don't think he executed as well as he did the triple twisting double. And maybe we'll see, because he normally has a 6.6. Here we are, handspring. That's still a pretty difficult first line. Double front 1.5 maybe.
Moved to Israel from Ukraine at the age of 12. Found it very challenging. Didn't speak the language. It was tough.
Oh, no, there's the triple twisting double. Shoulders down. I thought that was a double-double, but that when I look back on replay, it is the triple twisting double. So maybe he's gone for his usual options.
Oh, and there's the foot out as you picked it.
And quite off-centre.
So he can do better.
Yeah, all his landings were actually quite low with the shoulders down. Execution-wise, he normally does very well.
Score of 15 had put him in the lead. Is he there? Qualified with a 15-2. But he's let a couple of tenths go. Will it be Zapata? Still leading. Halfway through this field of eight. Two from Korea, one from China, one from Kazakhstan to come. And a 14.933. Now, that's exactly the same score, but they've separated them, I assume, on difficulty. 6.6 to 6.5. Yep. He's got Zapata by a tenth on difficulty. Oh, that's tough to swallow. If you raise Zapata. Anyway, we're not done yet. We're looking to see if anyone can crack the 15.
Well, we have got some. We have a couple of very, very strong contenders still. I don't think we need to rule anyone in or out yet.
Kim Hansol. From Seoul. It's his second Olympic Games. Seventh on floor at the 2019 Worlds. One floor at the Asian Games, 2018.
Double pike half out with just a small shuffle backwards. Combination line. Seeing some low shoulders on landings. Bit of a
No Korean medalists yet in these artists. Oh, goodness.
Messed that up. Rushed.
That's
his
a mess.
Feet on, well, not too dissimilar to what we saw earlier.
From Moldau.
Yep.
Look on his face. He knew that that was a big error. Last line.
Well, he's going to get a big deduction for that. Obviously losing the difficulty. The way he came out of that, plus the brushing of the feet on the floor like that, or the knees. It's a nervous start, isn't it?
Yes, and they're tripping themselves up on the more straightforward elements, particularly those swings.
Here's a double pike half out. At a Olympic final like this, there will be points taken off for feet not fully extended, even on the very difficult skills, the slightly crossed legs and so on. He's trying the 3.5 twist there. It's a tough landing position. Let's see what happens here. He's quite low. Legs drag, knees hit the floor, and it just interrupts his skill. His difficulty score will most certainly be down. Had a potential of around a 6.5. We'll see lower than that now.
Two-time winner of Korea's Best Gymnast Award, Kim Hansol. Well, it's done. Can't take it back. And he looks resigned to whatever comes his way. Be hoping for something over 14. To tip Yul Moldau out of third, perhaps. Still have three to come. Judges with a bit to think about after that routine. Hence the pause. Reassuring words, no doubt, from the coach. Not to worry. You made a final. You did your best.
I don't think I've ever seen that before. We're 6-3, so lost a fair bit there. Execution down. No, I haven't seen that happen before on those particular elements in a final.
13-0, 6-6. He has the same score as Nagorny. And below Nagorny again on difficulty. 0.1 separating them there. So Dolgopyat and Zapata. Dolgopyat holding down top spot on the difficulty tie break.
Now I think that Ryu is capable of taking the lead. It's posted a 15.066 in qualification.
Yes, and no one's cracked 15 yet. And the fearlessness of youth, perhaps, at 18 years of age. What have I got to lose?
It's first major event. First line completed with very little trouble. Combination line also done well. That's one of the better double pipe half outs we've seen.
Just kept it in, I think.
Yeah, I think so. He fought well.
Oh, well, not that time.
It's only a tenth, unless both feet went out, in which case it's a three-tenths. But moving quickly there. Geez, feet just about went outside then. Big hop forward on the triple. Finishes with a 3.5.
Well, it was an interesting routine. Yul Maldauer gives it generous applause. His alignment, he seems to pull himself out of the intended direction fairly often, but without getting into too much trouble.
Yeah, well, it's an interesting technique with the round-off. I won't go into it too much, but it looks like it's off direction, but it's deliberate to help with twisting.
Okay, good to know.
And there's 1.5 twisting double front. He's nice and square on his connection. Small landing errors like that are around about a 0.1.
Ryu Sung-hyun discovered the sport at the age of 8 when he was already playing football, and he had a lot of trouble talking his dad around to the idea of him pursuing gymnastics. Eventually, he wore his dad down, and here he is at the Olympics at 18. Oh, I think they're both out.
Feet are out.
Yeah.
So there's your 3/10, plus your deductions you had with the element leading to that out of bounds. This will be very close because difficulty-wise, 6.9, which was the highest of anybody in qualification. So if he can get the 6.9, he might be slightly forgiven for some of those execution errors.
But gosh, if he's out of top spot by less than 0.3, you start to wish your feet were a bit shorter.
I think Dolgopyat's going to keep this position. They've got that suspenseful music in the background again. It can't be helping anyone's health.
That's this sort of slow heartbeat sound that we get while we await a score that we all know is important, with just two to come. Show me, show me, show me. What's he done? 14-2-3-3 is into third position. So Dolgopyat and Zapata are safe for now, and Moldau has been pushed out of the medals. Wow, that's tough news, but he probably was expecting not to hold on. So Dolgopyat and Zapata, gold and silver at the moment, and Ryu Sung-hyun.
A bit of an emotional moment there. Don't rule out this man.
He's elegant, he's passionate, he's expressive, and he's already got a couple of medals.
The only thing for him, his difficulty is not as high, but his execution, one of the best. First two lines are looking great.
Good landings from XIAO Ruoteng, men's all-around silver medalist.
Nice connections. Showing lovely amplitude in his flares. Made a bit of a statement there, just showing how much in control he is.
XIAO Ruoteng, hang on. That might be good enough. He only needs to find a tenth from his qualifying score, and he'd be up there.
He's been very consistent. He's experienced. This is his, although it's his first Olympic Games, he has four world championships behind him.
Third place on floor at the 2019 Worlds.
3.5 to a front half and doesn't move a whisker at the end.
I don't want to put you on the spot too much, Liz. Did he put in anything extra, do you think, from qualifying?
I wouldn't. I don't have his routine written down from qualification. It's possible.
But he doesn't need much extra, and there's not a lot that went wrong here. Mm-hmm. It's going to be challenging, surely.
Yes, well, just remember he's done as many routines as Nagorny. He'll be tired. He's had a 6-2 in each of his three competition rounds for his difficulty. I think he's just relying on strong execution, and I feel he's executed this floor better than the others.
So it could be up on execution and chasing and difficulty. Mm. See what that means. He does love the performance side of gymnastics. He loves being on the stage. He admits it. He's not ashamed to say it. XIAO Ruoteng missed Rio through injury. He's making up for it here with a couple of medals already, but he doesn't have a gold.
This is going to be really close.
...14.766. He's in third position, so Dolgopyat and Zapata hang on. And Dolgopyat only has to see off one more, Milad Karimi, who was the eighth qualifier. So,
well, Karimi either will get gold. Like, if they've got to come ahead of Dolgopyat, they'll come ahead of Zapata at the same time. Hmm. So it'll shift them both down at the same time. He can't split them. He can either get the bronze or the gold. Qualifications, he had a 14.766, but in the all-around final, 15.033. So he is capable. 6.4 difficulty.
Yes, having said he's the lowest qualifier, you've got to keep in mind that next performance. And very well pointed out, Lizzie. Just 22, studying to be a PE teacher. Milad Karimi.
One and a half out of the floor and possibly out of medal contention as well. Foot almost slips out from underneath him.
Did well to save it. Well, a classy finish, but a couple of mistakes in there from Milad Karimi should mean that this man is your floor gold medalist. We'll wait for the scores to come in. Don't want to go off early. It's very tempting to, but we must wait. But there were some deductions in there for Milad Karimi. He knows it. But at 22, he's got some great years ahead of him and such an elegant worker. Fifth on floor at the Asian Games 2018. Eighth on high bar. He's gathering some good results.
Front handspring, double front tuck, half out. One, two, 3.5. I think it was to 2.5.
Dragged him out of the area, unfortunately.
Excellent twisting ability. They need to show at least one row which has a double rotation, double somersault. Can't just do all twisting. It's good elevation and finishes the floor with a triple.
14.77 would give him third.
I don't think he's going to top XIAO Ruoteng somehow.
At the moment, it's Israel, Spain, China. Into fifth place goes Milad Karimi with a 14.133. No change to the top three.
Coach has had the flags ready. It's a brilliant... And remember, it's a gymnast medal, and it's also all those around them that help them get there.
Absolutely. Never forget the sacrifices and the time put in by the coaches. But it's Artem Dolgopyat of Israel. Never has Israel picked up a medal in artistic gymnastics. Well, they've got the top prize now. And congratulations to Ray Zapata and XIAO Ruoteng, second and third.
Zapata matches his former, well, I suppose the former Olympic champion on floor. Oh, Havasio Defer, who won silver on floor.
And he credits Defer with keeping him in the sport. Zapata nearly flagged it away 10 years ago.
It was a bit of a war of attrition, that final. I think it unexpected result. In a way,
Ru of South Korea picks up fourth. Well, good competition. The favourite held on, but only by 0.1 in difficulty. Got a moment to explain how that tie breaks works. It's we've done our best with it.
I think you did well. if they get equal. First, like difficulty and execution score, then there's all sorts of permutations that go back according to how many, which judges gave which scores and so on and so forth. It's very complicated and only computers can work that out. But in essence, the higher difficulty will count.
And so we didn't have to drill down further.
Ruining what might have been.
Yes, that first pass was what let him down, but who knows whether it was fatigue or nerves. Being first up, Nagorny is a well-experienced performer. And Kim Hansol with a 13.066, finishing eighth. I see that one of the presenters for this medal presentation is an IOC member from Israel, Alex Giladi. They take a bit of a punt sometimes with these presenters. And, well, if that athlete gets up, then, you know, can I please be the presenter? I don't know how it works, but what I do know is an Israeli IOC member is coming out shortly to assist. Or at least scheduled to. Been told that we'll have these medal presentations after each event. There's different ways they can do it. They can have two events and then two medal presentations, but we think we're going one and one, one and one. Certainly they're setting up for it now, and so the medal presentation won't be far away. Setting up the temporary dais on the floor area. They can stay there now for subsequent presentations. This is the only floor exercise final tonight anyway. Presentation not far away. Do stay with us. Confirming results for you then, Artem Dolgopyat of Israel and Ray Zapata of Spain, separated on difficulty, even though they had the same total. XIAO Ruoteng of China picks up a third medal. And then Korea, Kazakhstan, United States, ROC and Korea again. The presenters are making their way to the dais area. That means our athletes can't be far behind. Medal presentation for the men's floor. It's interesting to watch Zapata. He's so passionate. He's a lot of fun. Dolgopyat has etched his name into history for Israel. XIAO Ruoteng. A third medal for him. You know, I was just wondering how Zapata might feel. He's been pipped out of top spot by a tenth on difficulty, but he looks overjoyed.
Yes, he's a medalist. He's a silver medalist at the Olympic Games here in Tokyo. Could have gone either way.
Alex Gilardi, Israeli IOC member, and from the FIG, we have Ali Al-Hitmi from Qatar. Their involvement is somewhat limited under these new presentation protocols. It's up to the athletes really to help themselves, but it's been working out all right. It's different, but it's fine. He's the men's all-around silver medalist. He's the men's team bronze medalist, and now bronze in the floor final. XIAO Ruoteng, the 25-year-old from Beijing, missed Rio through injury, and isn't he making up for it in Tokyo? Just loves tackling difficult elements and getting the better of them. That's what he likes most about being a gymnast, conquering something difficult. Ray Zapata, originally from Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic. He's been a resident of Spain for almost 20 years now. And a silver medalist. And isn't he feeling the moment?
Wonderfully emotional time. Overcome the enormity of his achievement.
So Artem Dolgopyat, born in Ukraine, moved to Israel at the age of 12, 2009, and he admits he had a very challenging time of it in those early days where he didn't speak the language, tried to talk to the other boys, ask them questions, but then he had to find someone who spoke Russian to translate for him, and slowly he started to understand Hebrew. He said he learned all his Hebrew at the gym, and now, through all those difficulties of relocating, the journey well worthwhile. His dad was a gymnast. Won't he be proud? Israeli flag hoisted for the first time at Olympic Artistic Gymnastics. It's interesting seeing these moments in history. There's a story somewhere in every event, a backstory, one of triumph over adversity or over injury. Self-doubt, resurrected careers. And so there you have them. Artem Dolgopyat, Rayderley Zapata, XIAO Ruoteng, Israel, Spain and China, men's floor medalists. Second final will be the women's vault. It's not far away. After the men clear the floor, after the photo opportunities, we'll be back with our next final. Shouldn't be too far away.
Kulam, Evet, kulam. See you.